that is elements, compounds and mixture. So previous class you have learned about matter, how matter is being classified is there is pure substance, mixed substance, and pure substance have been further classified into elements, compounds. Today, and even the elements have been classified based on their composition, that is metals, non-metals, metalloids, inert gases, all this we have learned in the previous class, right? Today, we will start with the symbols of elements. So, let us see first what is a chemical symbol. What is a chemical symbol? Chemical symbol is the representation of an atom, of an element, or element itself. So, this is about the chemical symbol. So, symbol means it is the representation. Yes, it is a representation of an atom, of an element, or element itself. Let us see an example. So, how to write the symbol for hydrogen? Yes, symbol for hydrogen. Let us see how to write the symbol for hydrogen. The symbol for hydrogen, is represented with capital H. It is represented by using the letter H. And this H, that is, it represents one atom of hydrogen. This symbol represents one atom of hydrogen. Okay, so hydrogen, the symbol will be written the capital letter H, and H represents one atom of hydrogen. Now, let us see, there are 2-3 scientists who have given different suggestions how to write the names of the chemical symbol. So first one is the Lavoisier, who introduced a new system, of nomenclature of elements. So Lavoisier was the scientist. Lavoisier, he introduced a new system of nomenclature of elements. He introduced a system, nomenclature of elements. And he suggested that the elements can be classified as gases, as earth metals, and non-metals. This was his suggestion. Now another scientist, that is Dalton. Another scientist named Dalton. He gave the atomic theory. He gave the atomic theory and he proposed. Now, what is atomic theory before I go forward? What is atomic theory? Atomic theory is a scientific theory that the matter is composed of discrete units or very small unit, that is called the atoms. So that is known as the atomic theory. So Dalton gave the atomic theory and he proposed a new set of standard formula for chemical elements. And each symbol is represented for one atom. And the formula of the compound was made by using these symbols. That was the suggestion, that is Dalton's suggestion. Now the third scientist, that is Berzelius, Johns Jacob Berzelius. Johns Jacob Berzelius. So Johns Jacob Berzelius was, yes, Johns Jacob Berzelius. He suggested that the use of letters. He suggested the use of letters. So the use of letters, they are easy to write and to print. And this method, or this was the suggestion done by Berzelius, and it is which are still used today. So till today, this method is used. So now let us see what are the suggestions what he had made. So first suggestion, that is the symbols. Symbols of some of the elements are derived from the first, that is from the English names. This first letter is derived from the English names and are represented, and it is represented in capital letters. So his suggestion, that is symbols are derived from the first letter of the English names and it is represented in capital letters. So let us see few symbols. Name of some symbols, that is of some elements, symbols of some elements. Hydrogen. Hydrogen is represented as H. The symbol for hydrogen, it is H. Carbon, C. Nitrogen, N. Oxygen, O. Phosphorus, P. Sulfur, S. Iodine, R. So these are the symbols of some of the elements. So you can see hydrogen, that is the first letter of hydrogen is H. So they have used the first letter and it is written in capital letter. That was the first suggestion. Now second, this, that is two letter symbols. What do you mean by two letter symbols? Here some of the elements, two or more elements have the first letter, same letter. For example, you can see calcium. When I write calcium, or when I write chlorine, calcium and chlorine, here the first letter begins with same letter, C, C. So one more letter is added to them to write the symbol. So that is the second two letter symbol. So here what happens, here calcium starts, the first letter starts with C, and even chlorine, the first letter starts with C. So in this, one more letter is added. That is why it is said to be two letter symbols. Yes, so calcium will be CA and chlorine will be CN. It is written, one more letter is added. So if you are having the same letters, first letter, one more letter is added. So let us see now two lettered symbols. Helium, yes, helium, HE. The symbol for the element is HE. Magnesium, MG. Aluminium, AL. Silicon, SR. Chlorine, CN. Calcium, CA. Manganese, ML. Cobalt, CO. ZN. So once again I will repeat. See, helium two letter, so HE. Magnesium, MG. Aluminium, AA. Silicon, SR. Chlorine, CN. Calcium, CA. Manganese, MN. Zinc, ZN. So cobalt, CO. So this is how the names. So let us see which are the elements that have been derived from Latin names. So symbols from Latin names, that is sodium. Sodium, the Latin name for sodium is lithium. Na, the symbol used for sodium is Na. Potassium, the Latin name is Coulomb, the symbol is K. Iron, it is ferrum. Fe, copper, the Latin name is Cupron. Cu, silver. Argentum, it is Ag. Gold, it is aurum. Au. Mercury, it is hydride. Hg. Lead, it is plumber. Pb. Tin, it is Sn. Stannum. So these are the Latin names used for the symbols. So sodium you will be writing the symbol Na, potassium K, iron Fe, copper Cu, silver Ag, gold Au, mercury Hg, lead Pb, tin Sn. So students, you need to learn all these symbols. It's already given in your textbook, so you can practice this symbols and learn it. Now let us come across what is called periodic table. What is a periodic table?
Represented as groups. So group will be represented
2A, 3B, like this. So it will be represented in groups. Now the horizontal, that is vertical columns, are known as groups. Now the first element that you can see here, like helium, lithium, sodium, potassium. Same way in groups also the elements have been arranged. Like that is 1A, 2A, 3B, like that, then name of the elements will be done in the periodic table. In the textbook, you can go through the periodic table which is given and just revise. So students, let us see now the chemical formula of elements. What do you mean by chemical formula of elements? Chemical formula of element is the representation. It is the representation. It is the representation of a molecule. It is a representation of a molecule of an element. It is a representation of a molecule of an element. It represents the number of atoms present in a molecule of an element. It is the number of atoms that is present in the molecule of an element. Let us see an example for this. It's the hydrogen molecule, that is H2. Hydrogen molecule, it is H2. The 2 represents, this 2 represents the number of, 2 represents the number of atoms that is present in a molecule of an element. Yes, it is the number. Now let us see what is atomicity. Now let us see what is atomicity. Atomicity is the number of atoms present in one molecule of an element. Atomicity is the number. It's the number of atoms. Number of atoms present in one molecule. In one molecule of an element. That is known as atomicity. Now, if a single molecule, that is a molecule containing a single atom, it is said to be monoatomic molecule. So, molecule containing, now what is monoatomic molecule? A molecule containing single atom, monoatomic molecule. Molecule containing single atom. That is known as monoatomic molecule. Example for monoatomic molecule, that is sodium, potassium. All these are examples for monoatomic molecule. Now, let us see what is diatomic molecule. That is molecule containing two atoms. Molecule containing two atoms is known as diatomic molecule. Let us give you an example that is for diatomic, that is hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. So hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, these are the examples for diatomic molecule. Now let us see what is triatomic molecule. Triatomic molecule. That is a molecule containing three atoms. Molecule containing three atoms known as as triatomic molecule. Example of a triatomic molecule, that is water. Water, the molecular formula of water is H2O. It contains two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. So 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 atoms are present. Even carbon dioxide. All these are examples for triatomic molecule. Yes? Then, what is known as polyatomic molecule. Now let us see what is polyatomic molecule. Polyatomic molecule. Polyatomic molecule means a molecule made up of more than one atom. So many. That is known as polyatomic molecule. Example for polyatomic molecule, that is sulfur, S8, phosphorus, P4. All these are examples for polyatomic molecule. So students, today we have learned about the symbols and the names of the certain elements, that is starting from capital letters, and some of the elements are derived with two letter symbols. Then we have learned some of the elements derived from Latin names. Yes. Then we have learned about periodic tables, that is how it has been shown, that is horizontal rows and vertical columns. Then we have learned chemical formula of elements. Yes. And so with this, let me wind for today, children. See you soon.